As we discussed at the end, we had many failures in drug development due to lack of efficacy of the drugs. So it's important for us at Pharma to check as early as possible that the drug we develop may be efficacious on disease. So I took an example that was developed by a Danish team, published last year, a very interesting example of what we call Mendelian randomization study. It's a tool, it's a special tool to look for causality, meaning that we need to check whether the target, what we try to manipulate with drugs, is truly associated with the drug. And I took the example of the NASH. As people know very well that NASH is secondary to many risk factors that are common to ischemic heart disease. So it's obvious that NASH and ischemic heart disease are linked. But the question was, outside of this common risk factor like lipids, is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease truly in causal relationship with ischemic heart disease? In other words, does non-alcoholic fatty liver disease increase the risk of a myocardial infarction? So I illustrated the method that was used based on the distribution of genetic variants in a large population. And the Danish team that worked on this question demonstrated very nicely that the link between NAFLD and ischemic heart disease was totally true, but was due to common risk factors, including lipids and diabetes. The main issue of such method is that it needs a very large number of patients, very large cohort, fully genotype with well phenotype, and this cannot be performed by a single team, either academic or industry. So the objective of my talk was to demonstrate that there is a dramatic need for collaboration between private and public partners in order to solve very important questions and to lead to the development to novel drugs or novel treatments that will improve patient health. And it's especially true in the cardiometabolic field where we had some advances with ischemic heart disease due to this consortium, but we still need a lot of additional data to better understand heart failure with preserved ejection fraction, for instance, or maybe atrial fibrillation.